Hey everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. In this tips and tricks video, we're going to learn how to use the pose controls window to create poses, as well as use those poses to help create a looping walking animation. So what we've got here is we've got a characterized character that we have a control rig on, and we're just going to kind of go through here and move, let's say, some of these limbs. It doesn't really matter what we move them to, or where we move them to, I should say. Just as long as we're, you know, the pose is actually just a little different and more interesting than what we have to begin with. So I'm just going to go ahead and move a few more of these. Oops. Okay, now let's say that this is about the pose that we want to create, or basically store and use later. So what we can do from here is we can go to Window, Pose Controls, and we'll see we've got this window here that pops up. So from here what we can do is we can go ahead and click this plus sign, and inside of our preview window here, we'll see that under the Thief Girl pose, we've got the pose that we have selected here. It basically just takes a screenshot of it, of whatever selected as well. As you can tell, it's got the rotation here. So if you want to do, let's say, not have this rotation icon in here, we can just hit the trash key and then just go ahead and redo that pose. So now that we've got this pose created, we can essentially add it to any character that has a control rig assigned to it. Now granted, this is the only character that we have in this example, but if we were to save this scene, if we had another scene open with a different character in it, we could go ahead and import just or merge just this pose or the poses that we have stored here for this file. So what we can do from here, just to reapply it, let's say if I wanted to maybe rotate the hips that way and move them. Just going to create a different pose to show that we can kind of go back to it here. So if we wanted to reapply this pose, all we'd have to do is just simply double click on it. And it's going to basically apply that pose of whatever controller we have selected. And the reason why it's doing whatever controller is because if we look in the character controls window, which I had just off screen here, under this controls window, it shows that we just have the body part selected. So that basically means that it's only going to apply this pose to that body part. So if I were to select the wrist here, for example, and double click this pose again, it would go ahead and apply it to that basically that body part, which in this case is just that limb. But if I wanted to do the whole body, I can just go ahead and select the full body key right here, and then I can select pretty much any controller, double click, and it'll just go ahead and move that into position. So also in this pose controls window, what we have control over are some of these options down here, which is to translate the X, Y, and Z, and the rotate. And what these do is we can actually turn some of these off. So if we didn't want to, let's say, apply rotation or translation, or let's say translation on a certain axis or two, we could go ahead and turn those off, and when we apply this pose, it wouldn't actually apply those to the given controller or the full body. Now another thing we can do is if this we click this M button, we have the option of mirroring a pose. So if I go ahead and reselect this and I double click my Thief Girl pose, you'll see that it's actually mirroring the pose itself. Now I've got it set to the hip, so it's kind of reoriented a bit, but if I went to, let's say, the foot here, oops, and turn off my mirror, you'll see that it's actually going to mirror back and forth based upon whether I had that mirror selected or not. And that's helpful if you're, let's say, creating a walk cycle and you want to start on one side and maybe end on the other, or, you know, there are various situations where you're going to want to use the mirroring of a pose and not just have to create that second pose on the opposite side. Okay, so to now use this within the context of an example, let's say we've got this walk animation here, and we want to make it a cycle. And as we can see right now, if I go ahead and play this, you might not be able to see it in playback depending on the frame rate, but if I definitely toggle back and forth between the last frame and the first frame, we'll see that they're not the same. So what we can do here is, I've got this pose that's stored up in the pose controls. I went ahead and created a new animation layer, and with my character controls set to key the full body, what I'm going to do is just select my right ankle, since that's the one I'm going to want to basically create the pose off of. And I've got that first pose. Basically, this pose that I saved is the first pose in this cycle. So if I go to and set a key there on the first frame, and then I go to the end frame here, I can just double click this walk pose, and you can tell it's going to realign that pose, and now we'll have an animation that loops. Okay, well, that concludes this week's tips and tricks video. Thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.